Hi guys, guess what? It's nearly Christmas! It's exciting! I've got a book here called Olivia Helps with Christmas about a little piggy called Olivia. And I'm going to dedicate this story to my great niece, Olivia, who lives in London. Hi Olivia! 'Twas the day before Christmas, and Olivia and her family had been busy all morning with last minute shopping. Olivia was exhausted, and yet there was still so much to do. Look, they bought a Christmas tree. Do you have a Christmas tree? Olivia told her father, Kurt, to put up the tree. Daddy, put up the Christmas tree. She's a bit bossy, isn't she? So she could help her mother with William's lunch. Is William the baby brother? William, Olivia, what are you feeding him? Blueberry pie, mummy. Oh, darling, that's going to make him sick. Oh, no. The baby brother's been sick all over the kitchen floor. Whoops. Sweetheart, Santa... Oops. By 4 o'clock, Olivia was getting very impatient. Look, she's looking up the chimney. Sweetheart, Santa won't come for hours, said her mother. Now wipe the soot off your snout and help me untangle these lights. Look, they've got Christmas lights, haven't they, for the tree? And what's Olivia doing? Oh no, Mummy! Darling, it's much easier if you plug them in first. See, isn't that better? Finally, the tree was all ready. 5 p.m. Watching for Santa. No Santa. Rain. Olivia wanted to help even more. Mummy, can I set the table for Christmas Eve dinner? Oh yes, Olivia, that would be very helpful. Why, that's beautiful, darling. Wherever did you get that perfect little tree? What has Olivia done? She's hacked off the top of the Christmas tree, look. Oh, what a naughty little piggy. Olivia's father came along to make a fire so it would be cosy. Daddy, what are you thinking? You don't want to cook Santa. 7 o'clock, watching for Santa. No Santa, but no rain. After dinner, the family gathered around to sing Christmas carols, and they all started singing. Deck the halls with boughs of holly. Tra-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Olivia likes singing. Finally, the most important task of the night, leaving some treats out for Santa by the chimney. Olivia said, now it's time to wait. And her mother said, now it's time for bed. Come on, Olivia. Bye-bye, says doggy. Nom, 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 says doggy. Oh no, what's the doggy doing? But Olivia wasn't at all sleepy. She tossed and she turned and she was too hot and she was too cold. And then she heard something up on the roof. Could it be Santa? Oh no, it's a squirrel.
No, it's a cat.
Is it a cat? Maybe it's a raccoon. It seemed that she would never go to sleep until she woke up and it was morning. Olivia ran down to get her brothers. Noiselessly. They look very noisy, but it says noiselessly, that's strange. They crept down the stairs and looked out of the window. Snow! Presents! Yay! Stockings! Look, Santa's been! He left us some presents and he ate all the cookies and he drank all the milk. And what does the dog say? Oh no, that cheeky doggy. Now children, said Olivia's mother, Abigail, finish your breakfast and then you can open your presents under the tree. Yeah! They're so fast. Look at them ripping open their presents. Oh my goodness. It looks like someone just learned how to walk. Yes, look, Olivia's baby brother, William. He's crawled over to the tree on his own. Clever little William. Oh, I can't turn the pages on this book. They're all flappy. Here's the presents. Some of Santa's offerings were better than others. Pajamas, skis, a jersey, a toboggan, booties, Maracas! Cheeky, cheeky, cheeky. The children thanked Santa and their parents for a wonderful Christmas, and Olivia announced, "Now I have a present for you, Daddy. It's a self-portrait." Wouldn't it be good over the fireplace? Do you think the daddy likes a self-portrait? He doesn't look very happy, does he? "Well," said Olivia, "I think I'll hit the slopes." She's going skiing. Whee! Ploff! She landed on her snout. Oh, look, here comes the brother. Whee! And he went over Olivia. Skiing takes a bit more practice than tobogganing. Olivia and Kurt, that's the daddy, they worked all afternoon building a snowman, and Olivia dressed it. Do you think the snow pig looks a bit like them? That evening, Olivia finally allowed her father to build a fire. The family sat around and warmed their trotters, while Olivia's mother brought them steaming cups of cocoa. Soon it was time for bed, but Olivia wasn't at all sleepy. Or so she said. Before the lights were even out, she fell into a deep, dreamless sleep. Well, not quite dreamless. Look, what's she dreaming about? The Nutcracker. She's a ballet dancer. Oh, that's a nice book. That's a book about Christmas. And do you know what? I've got another book about Christmas. It's kind of about all the seasons, but it's got a little bit of Christmas in it. And this is another Julia Donaldson book. You can tell I'm a fan of Julia Donaldson. It's called Stickman. It starts in the spring. Stickman lives in the family tree with his stick lady loves and their stick children, three. One day he wakes up and he goes for a jog. Stickman, oh Stickman, beware of the
dog.
A stick, barks the dog. An excellent stick, the right kind of stick for my favourite trick. I'll fetch it and drop it, then fetch it again, and I'll drop it and fetch it, then drop it again. I'm not a stick. Why can't you see? I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, that's me. And I want to go home to the family tree. Look, the doggy's fetching him all the time and the boy's throwing him. She's going roller skating, isn't she? It must be springtime in the park, because look, there's blossom on the trees. The notice said, dogs must be kept on a lead. At last, the game's over, and Stickman is freed. He sets off home with a hop and a twirl. Stickman, oh Stickman, beware of the girl. A stick, cries the girl with a smile on her face. The right kind of stick for poo sticks and winning a race. Look, they're standing on the bridge playing poo sticks. Have you ever played poo sticks? It's fun. You stand on a bridge and you drop sticks and then you run to the other side and see whose stick goes under first. Has everyone got one? Ready to throw? It's one, two, three. Into the river we go. Then they run to the other side of the bridge. Those sticks are winning and Stickman's behind. I'm not a poo stick. Why can't they see? I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, that's me. And I'm heading away from the family tree. Look, he's going down the river, isn't he? And he lives that way. Stickman is floating. He floats on and on. Stickman, oh Stickman, beware of the swan. A twig, said the swan. This twig is the best. It's the right kind of twig to weave into my nest. She's going to have a baby. I'm not a twig. Why can't they see? Look, there she is sitting on her nest. I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, that's me. And the babies have hatched. And there they go with their mummy and daddy. And I long to go back to the family tree. The nest is deserted and Stickman is free. He drifts down the river and sails out to the sea. That's quite dangerous. He tosses and turns till the frolicking foam washes him up on a beach far from home. Maybe they're at the seaside, aren't they? Look, there's somebody with a spade and there's some people with doing some swimming and on the beach and there's an old castle. Here comes a dad with a spade in his hand. Oh Stickman, beware of the sand. A mast, yells the dad. An excellent mast. Look, he's got a flag, hasn't he? Hooray, there's a flag on our castle at last. I'm not a mask for a silly old flag, or a sword for a knight, or a hook for a bag. I'm not a pen, I'm not a bow, I'm not a bat or a boomerang, no. Do you see how the season's changed? What season is it here? It's summer, isn't it? And then, as the pictures go along, it turns to autumn and then winter. Look, now it's winter. Stickman, oh Stickman, beware of the snow. Here comes a boy in a warm woolly scarf. An arm for my snowman, he says with a laugh. That's a funny snowman. I'm not an arm, can't anyone see? I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, that's me. Will I ever get back to the family tree? Oh dear, he's been gone a long time. Stickman is lonely, Stickman is lost. Stickman is frozen and covered in frost. Stickman is weary, his eyes start to close. Look, you see, do you remember the snowman had melted and he's lying there? His eyes start to close, he stretches and yawns and lies down for a doze. That's very dangerous, to go to sleep in the snow, because he'll never wake up again, he'll freeze. Stay awake, Stickman. He can't hear the bells or the sweet singing choir. That's what they do in England, they do carol singing. Or the voice that says, here is a stick for the fire. Uh-oh. Stickman is lying asleep in the grate. Can anyone wake him before it's too late? Do you think they're going to set fire to the sticks? Oh no. He dreams of his kids and his stick lady love. And suddenly awakes. What's that noise from above? It starts with a chuckle and then turns into a shout. Ho, ho, ho! Oh, I'm stuck! Get me out! A stuck man, a stuck man? Who could that be? Don't worry, quite stick man, I'll soon set you free. Who do you think it could be up the chimney? Look, there's a boot, a scratch and a scrape and a flurry of soot, a wiggle, a jiggle and out pokes a foot. A shove and a nudge and a hop and a jump, and Santa falls into the room with a thump. There he is! Stickman, oh Stickman, you excellent friend. Thanks a million. Thanks without end. The cat's frightened. Look, he's on the tree. It's the Gruffalo's child. Then Stickman helps Santa deliver the toys to fast asleep girls and fast asleep boys. Faster and faster they fly through the snow till Santa says only one chimney to go. Look where they are. Does anybody recognise that tree? Yeah. Look, in their little bed made of birch and leaves, and the mummy's putting the children in bed. Stick lady's lonely, the children are sad. It won't feel like Christmas without their stick dad. They toss and they turn in the family bed. But what's that cluttering sound overhead? Somebody's tumbling into their house. Is it a bird or a bat or a mouse? Or could it be? Yes, could it possibly be? I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, I'm Stickman, that's me. And I'm sticking right here in the family tree. Look, Santa's delivered Stickman home again for Christmas. And look, there's a little table with some blueberries and some mushrooms. Bye-bye, Santa. Bye-bye. Happy Christmas, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the stories. Bye. See you next year.